great. I'm ready to take the plunge. I'm going to do a full face TCA peel, which I have not done before. This is from Makeup Artist Choice, and I'll be using the 18% TCA solution. And that's the same one that I've been using in my TCA spot treatment videos. So here are the ingredients. So this is like a cooking video right now. So I just have some towels on hand, my Makeup Artist Choice TCA peel brochure, which has all the instructions and what you need to provide, and they also give like extra warnings for peels that are 15% or higher. So there's 15%, 18, 21, and 24 TCA percent that they sell. I have my trusty timer at 5 minutes, cotton pads, cotton swabs, a pair of latex gloves. I have my TCA solution, my green tea and pomegranate cleanser. So I'm going to be using the recommended neutralizing solution that they have listed in the brochure. It's 2 tablespoons of baking soda and 1.5 cups of water. What's not mentioned in the brochure is using alcohol, but I've seen other videos where people doing TCA peels will use alcohol before their peel to prep the skin, to remove all oil and cleanser from their skin before they do their peel. So I'll try it too. Here's Vaseline, also Aquaphor, and the Vaseline is to put around the nose area, around your eye sockets and your mouth. Aquaphor is to keep your skin moist. I also have the triple antibiotic ointment that I'll put on immediately after doing the peel. Post-peel, it's recommended to use a sunscreen of 30 SPF or higher. And this is a 30 plus SPF from Elta MD, and this one is 40. Both of these sunscreens are moisturizing, and they're used in dermatologist's office, you know, for just this after chemical peels. So I'll be safe with those. Also, I have the hydrocortisone cream that's recommended by Makeup Artist Choice, and just to help with my moisture on my skin barrier, I have the CeraVe PM. So I might not use it immediately, but these, but I might use it, you know, later. So these are all my products that I'll be using, and I have a fan on hand. Yay! So pretty much here's everything, and just want to let you know that I did take some ibuprofen maybe 10-15 minutes ago, so I'll let that kick in before I start, and I will be recording the process as well as doing a kind of video diary to let you know how my peel is going. Okay, and I appreciate you watching. Thanks. So here we are. We're going to do a full facial TCA peel, and for me, it's kind of a scary thing because I've never done the full face. I've done spot treatment, so I know kind of what to expect with my skin peeling and healing. But the reason why I'm doing a full face is because I do want to clear up some of the lightened spots that I have here. So as you can see, my hyperpigmentation and freckles and age spots have lightened quite a bit just from using sunscreen, the lightening serums, and also doing you know, different chemical peels, but it still looks kind of muddy. So I want to see if I can clear up some of those really light ones that you know, are just kind of hanging in there. So I also want to point out that I had a couple breakouts. So I have this spot, this one, this one, this one, and this one. And I think it's from using the retinoid. I was using triacneal, and that was in my nighttime skin routine video, so I have stopped using that. And that's considered purging. So they say it happens with products that have like a vitamin A active in it. So even those who are using Retin A, you know, they say, you know, the doctors will tell you your skin's going to get worse before it gets better. So that's what happened. And normally my hormonal breakouts don't happen in those particular places. So it's a concern because it wasn't a normal thing for me, and I didn't want to wait it out to see more purging or having to deal with that. So I just stopped using the retinoid altogether. But the mandelic acid peels were actually helping heal them. So whenever I use it, they would dry up and kind of clear up. So, you know, love the mandelic. So I have already mixed my solution. It took a while for the baking soda to fully dissolve in the water. So that's already prepped. I'm going to start with taking my cotton pad and clearing on my face of oil and cleanser. So I already washed my face with the green tea pomegranate cleanser, and I just splashed it off. I did not use the towel like I normally do, but I did blot my face dry. So right now this is alcohol. The only one I had was 91% isopropyl alcohol, so not sure what that's going to actually do to my skin, but heck, we're going to put TCA on it anyway. So, ooh, boy, it stinks. Okay. Just the fumes of the alcohol is pretty annoying. So, and like I mentioned, I did take 600 milligrams of ibuprofen, and I also took an allergy pill just in case. So usually if I get like some kind of allergic reaction, then it affects my peels as well. So okay, so I'm going to toss the alcohol pad, and that was pretty bad altogether. Okay, next thing is to prep the sensitive areas with Vaseline. So they say to put on your lips and around the mouth, nostrils, and around your eyes. So and I like these squeeze tubes of Vaseline. It's so much neater. And I already warned the family that I'm doing this and it's going to look pretty bad. So they're aware. I didn't want them to freak out. And right now is the only time really to do it because it is, you know, winter break for us. So take advantage of it. I will be missing, you know, New Year's Eve events, but that's okay. Most of our thing is, you know, Thanksgiving and Christmas anyway, so not a big deal. Okay, so here's, that was it for the Vaseline. Sorry, I have to wipe it off. Okay, so in the brochure for, you know, the user's manual for the TCA peel, it says to use Q-tips because it's a lot softer than gauze, like cotton gauze, but because the face is a large area and I'm doing a higher percentage of TCA, I should, I wanted to use something that could cover a broader area quicker because the process time is going to be so much faster. So I have my cotton pad here. So we'll put on our gloves because TCA will eat through the skin on your hands as well. So I'm gonna do that. And when you purchase the kits from Make a Bar's Choice, actually include the gloves, but I just purchased these because I don't know where I put those. Okay, so here we go. I have my solution mixed. I'll stir it again. Okay, so I'm going to start with the forehead and swipe it on liberally. And it's already kind of stinging. So I'm going in this pattern because I kind of know where my sensitive areas are on my face. My cheekbones are very sensitive. I'll just go right to the jawline. Then we'll wait for it to frost. So I think I'll add a little more. I'll do one more pad just in case. Let me see. So it is stinging quite a bit. Sure, I got everything. So I think it's already processing. Alright, I'm going to rinse my gloves and I'm going to get ready to process. Oh, I didn't put my timer on. Oh well. Okay, so I'm going to be watching for the frosting, which is coming in actually pretty quickly. So I'm putting on the fan. So I can see the cheeks frosting already, and it is getting lighter up here and around here. So I'm going to soak this baby washcloth in the solution. And get it ready. So when you see me stepping away, it's to get to the fan. So I'll neutralize the cheek area since that's frosting first. It seems like the nose area is kind of frosting as well. Down here. So it does sting when you put the neutralizer on, because you're touching this area that's just been treated. So it's you can feel the coolness of the washcloth and the solution, but you feel the stinging. It just feels like sharp needles. So after I neutralize, then I'll be washing my face again with the green tea pomegranate solution, the cleanser. So I'm going to stop my timer because I didn't start it on the right time anyway. So processing for the TCA is super quick. So. It's hard to get like a accurate time. So for these large spots here, this is actually treatment number 10 for them, because I've done 9 other spot treatments on these spots and a few less on that side, but just wanted to see if they're still recording. Oh my goodness. But I can see my skin already kind of wrinkling. It looks tight. Sure, you get everything. So the fan does help with the cooling. So I think that's about it for neutralizing, and I'll be washing my face, making sure that all the TCA solution is off. I'll wash that later. So, okay, I'll wash my face and then I'll be back. Okay, I'm back, and I just washed my face with the cleanser, and it's still a little white. You can see some frosting, but my spot treatments have frosted more than this. So, you know, this is my first TCA peel, so I just don't want to go too heavy or aggressive. I thought I would use the Q-tips to double up the TCA on my large spots, but just kind of like, okay, be a little bit more conservative and take it easy. You know, I can always do this again. So what I'm going to do next is apply the triple antibiotic, you know, if you have like Neosporin or whatever, to my entire face, because this is what I would do anyway for my my spot treatment. So even though the skin's not broken, you still want to protect the skin
while it is very fragile. So you can feel it, it's kind of tingly. So. And it's really important to continue to moisturize and keep the skin soft, so you have less chance of it cracking as it gets dry and heals. So. But this feels good, putting this thing over. And my face is kind of warm. It does feel a little warm, but not too bad. Make sure I get everything. I can feel just a little bit of tingling whenever I go over or just put a little pressure on the skin. So like others before me, this is kind of a drastic kind of thing for your skin. But I mean, if you do it cautiously and, you know, you prepare yourself for it, then you can do it very safely. Okay, so I think that's it. And so in the process, the white is supposed to go down and the skin will eventually turn a little bit red, and then it's supposed to turn more like that brown, scabby, and peel off. So anyway, thank you for spending all this time with me, and if you have any questions, leave them below, and we'll see you next time. So thank you. Bye.